A friend who realizes, who helps you to realize God's purpose in your life. Are you the kind of friend who helps another person realize God's purpose in their life? Or you are the kind of friend who takes them happening because it is not on shine of late to be so much into religion? What kind of friend are you? A friend like Ruth. You know, in the story of Ruth and Naomi, Ruth was not obliged to stay with Naomi, was she? Was she obliged?
No. She was young. She could have gotten another man because she so wanted. She could have gotten another man. But she said, I am not leaving you. I am staying. Because her husband had a time. So she was free to go. She could have stayed. And she said, no. Actually, she could have gone out, but she said, I'm staying behind. That's the kind of friend we need to have. That's the kind of friend that we need to be. To stand with our friends in the face of adversity. To encourage and empower in times of uncertainty. Are you that kind of friend? The greatest want of this world is the want for men and women who are going to stay faithful, fiercely faithful to their work and duty. Now, I always hear it. Sometimes I hear people say, I don't like working for Seventh Adventists. Have you heard about it?
Yes.
I don't like working for Seventh Day Adventists. And there are also employers who say, I don't like employing Seventh Day Adventists because they are lazy. Have you heard about it? They are lazy, they take work for granted. That's not what the Bible tells us to do. Like Nehemiah, do you know that when the children of Israel went into exile, Nehemiah was a cupbearer, isn't he? Wasn't he a cupbearer? To King Artaxerxes, isn't he? Now, Nehemiah had been in a position of authority because he was a prophet, isn't he? Back in his homeland, he was a respected person, but now here, he's just a simple cup there. Being a cupbearer is not a position you very much talk about with so much prestige and pride. But Nehemiah earned the recognition and respect of King Artaxerxes after 20 solid years of serving him. After 20 solid?
Yes.
Don't you find it strange that a cupbearer would just walk up to a king and ask on behalf of all these exiles to be allowed and accepted to go back to their homeland? And the king accepted? Don't you wonder? Just imagine. Let's put it back to Pharaoh. If just a normal servant could just walk up to Pharaoh and tell Pharaoh, Pharaoh, I have a request on behalf of my tribe to allow us to go back to our home country. Would that come so easy? And yes, that is what was given to Nehemiah. But why? Because of his faithfulness to his work and duty. Now that is the kind of faithfulness that God wants us to have. Like Noah. How long did Noah take building the ark? Answers? How long did Noah take building the ark?
120 years.
Yes?
120 years.
For 120 years. Solid years. Doing one thing. And yet there are some of us who do something for 6 months and then we are done. Like, no, this is not working. This relationship is not working. 6 months, 2 months, 1 year. It's not working. I'm throwing it down the drain. 120 years, Noah was faithful to his duty. And he used the ark to patiently endure and carry through the task we are given until it is done. Even here as church, how do we execute our duties? Or We do because somebody else will do. So we keep doing, living the path for them. How faithful are you doing the duty that you are given? Sometimes it needs us to be fiercely faithful to go forward even when it looks stupid to do so. Especially to those who do not share a similar calling like ours. It looks so stupid for Noah to push on. Because for 120 years, people did not see the sense in what he was doing. 120 years, someone could have said, you know, Noah started building that ark when I was still a young child. I grew up seeing Noah building that ark. Surprisingly, I am 90 years old and Noah is still doing the what? Still building the ark. Why do you see the logic in that? And yet, he never stopped building the ark. Because he was true to his duty, because he was called by God. He had a greater calling. The want for men and women.
proven, never proven.
Fine.
I tell you what I know.
You'll be alive.
Getting
knowing that you could never, ever admit what you've done.
Why? Can we track it down?
They want Joy is telling you.
Bedroom. Hurrah. That's to be. On route to
thinking about this. So here. She doesn't speak to anyone else. Okay. So far.